I was diagnosed with Hodgkin's lymphoma in 2004 while on a study abroad trip to Spain. I was 21 years old. No one expects for you to have a life-threatening illness when you're in your 20s. I saw a variety of doctors and received a multitude of misdiagnoses, from bipolar disorder to an ear infection to irritable bowel syndrome. After a month and a half in Spain, I felt what was a tumor. All the preliminary tests were done. I had surgery to debulk and kind of remove some tumor around my esophagus and trachea because I was having so much trouble breathing. Following that surgery, I caught a flight back to Houston and began chemotherapy. After my first treatment, I basically spent the month of December alone in my apartment watching TV and crying, and I just felt so alone. My friends didn't understand me anymore. I didn't understand me anymore. After my radiation was over, it was kind of like the doctor said, okay, see you in 1 month. You're done. And then the emotional turmoil started. You're in a whirlwind. You're in shock. You're in denial. You're not considering the psychological aspects of what's happening to you and what a trauma it is. Welcome to my home pharmacy. No, I'm not hoarding for a bird flu pandemic. I'm a very sarcastic person, and it's just this no holds barred type of approach to cancer. I make fun of it. I offer my friends Ensure when they come in and visit me, or I'll make jokes about my hair or my white blood cell count. It's a positive way of looking at the experience, and it's very therapeutic. I think I've probably earned myself a honorary degree in pharmacology by now, so that's my stash. I was in remission for 3 years, and I relapsed in December of 2007. With relapse, there's such a feeling of defeat. It's very profound, and it's very hard to want to fight again. I am 57 days post-transplant. I had an autologous transplant, which is where I donated my own cells. This is Beam, my lovely dragon. He's all, he's in protective isolation right now. He's named after the chemotherapy regimen, high-dose chemotherapy regimen I went through when I had my stem cell transplant. I think a big thing was before my treatment, I was able to take steps to preserve my fertility. The bone marrow transplant that I had, you have about a 90% chance of never having ovarian function again. The fertility treatment process was not as painful as cancer treatment. It did not have any effect on my treatment. In fact, my tumor actually shrunk a bit as a result of the hormone therapy. I think it's very important that patients are educated about fertility preservation, because it's very important for your self-worth to know that you have that chance. My eggs actually, ironically, they are just across the street. Every day I pass by, and it's nice to know that my future babies might be there, frozen. With Hodgkin's disease, the first time you're diagnosed, everyone is so reassuring, and you have a 95% chance, and Hodgkin's, that's the best disease to have. You're gonna have cancer. Well, now the chances are more like 50%, but it does give me optimism, and it makes life a lot sweeter and a lot more meaningful. And I think that what you do with your life, what I'm gonna do with my life in the future, it will have meaning.